Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss optimization problems. Let's go ahead and work through this example. Find the dimensions of a rectangle with area 100 feet squared, whose perimeter is as small as possible. Let's work through it. Solution. We'll start this problem by drawing a picture of the rectangle. Maybe it looks something like this. And we should probably label the sides. So if I call this bottom side X, because it's a rectangle, the top side is also X. If the left side is Y, then the right side is also Y. Now that we have our picture, let's write down what we're given in the problem and what we need. So we're given some important information. Let's see, it says, find the dimensions of the rectangle with area 100 feet squared. So we're told that the area is equal to 100. But the area is equal to the length times the width. That means that X times Y is equal to 100. Very, very useful. I'm going to put that in a box because we're going to be using that. Now let's write down what we need. Well, the question wants us to find the dimensions of the rectangle with area 100 feet squared, so we've used that, whose perimeter is as small as possible. We basically want to make the perimeter small. We need to minimize the perimeter. Okay, we need to make it as small as possible. That's why it's called an optimization problem. Optimization problems are concerned with maximizing and minimizing various things. So we can write down a formula for the perimeter. I'll call it big P. The perimeter is basically the sum of the lengths of the sides. So it'd be x plus x, which is 2x, plus, and then y plus y, which is 2y. But this is a function of two variables. And at this point in time, we don't really know how to, minimize functions of two variables. So what we're going to do is we're going to use our condition, x, y equals 100, to make it a function of one variable. So if we take x times y equals 100 and divide both sides by x, we get y equals 100 over x. Now let's plug this into p. So p equals 2x plus 2 times 100 over x, just replacing the y with 100 over x. So now we have a pure function of x. We can attempt to minimize it. In order to do that, we're going to have to take the derivative and set it equal to 0 to find critical numbers. We want to write it in a way that allows us to do that. Let's start by writing it like this, maybe p of x. You can certainly do that. And this is equal to 2x plus, and then 2 times 100 is 200. So now I'm going to bring the x upstairs. And because there's a 1 on the exponent, it's going to become negative like this. You'll get a negative 1 as the exponent. Okay, now we're ready to minimize this. So we'll take the derivative and set it equal to 0. F prime of x is equal to, let's see, the derivative of 2x, well, that's just going to be 2 because the derivative of x is 1. And for this other piece, the 200 times x to the negative 1, you can just bring down the negative 1 and put it in the front. And then subtract 1 from the exponent, so minus 2. And want this to be equal to 0. So we're going to find the critical numbers of this function and use what's called the second derivative test. So let's keep going. At this point, what we can do is we can basically add this piece to the other side. So we have 2 equals adding the 200x to the negative 2. It'll look like this. And then we can bring that x to the negative 2 downstairs. So it will look like this, 200 over x squared. And multiply by x squared. That'll give us 2x squared equals 200, and then divide by 2. That gives us, I'm going to come over here because we have all this room, x squared equals 100. Take the square root of both sides, and we get x equals plus or minus 10. Automatically, we know we can reject the answer negative 10 by the physical nature of this problem, right? It's a rectangle. You cannot have a negative length, so x must be equal to 10. And then to find your y, you basically take your x and you plug it into your formula, which is 100 over x. So y is equal to 100 over x, 100 over 10, that's equal to 10. So the answers are x equals 10 and y equals 10. However, there is something that needs to be said and something that needs to be done. So we know this is the answer because x can't be negative, so it must be 10, because this question has a physical interpretation, and so it should have a solution, and we found it. However, mathematically, we should still verify that x equals 10 is going to give us a minimum, right? We need to verify that. So to do that, what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to use the second derivative test. Recall, second derivative test says, if you let f prime of c be equal to 0, if the second derivative is positive at c, then you're going to have a min at c, a min at x equals c. It's backwards, positive min, and if it's negative at c, you're going to have a max at x equals c. This is extremely important to do in pretty much every single problem you do involving optimization. So after you find your critical number, like I did here, we found our 10, I went ahead and got both answers, but you're still supposed to check that it's actually a minimum. So let's go ahead and do it. All we have to do to verify it's a minimum is basically find the second derivative and plug in 10. So our first derivative is up here. It's p prime of x equals 2 minus 200 x to the negative 2. So if we take the derivative of that, well, the derivative of 2 is 0. We can bring down the negative 2. It'll give us 400 x to the negative 3. So p double prime of x is equal to 400 over x cubed. And so now we actually plug in the 10. So p double prime of 10 is equal to 400 over 10 cubed. And it doesn't matter what number this is, it just matters that it's positive. So we have a, remember it's backwards, if it's positive you have a min. So we have a min at x equals 10. And this is absolutely key. I'm just gonna circle this because this is super important. This is like one of the most common mistakes that people make when they're learning optimization. They learn how to find the answer, but they forget to check the second derivative test. Let's just briefly go through the whole problem one more time just to make sure you got it, because once you can do one of these, in theory, you can do other problems. Even though they're all different, they all follow the same format. The question wanted the dimensions of a rectangle with area 100 feet squared, whose perimeter is as small as possible, okay? So we write down a picture of the rectangle because it's talking about a rectangle. We labeled everything, x and y. We're given that the area is 100 feet squared. So that means that x times y is 100. And we need to minimize the perimeter, which is the sum of the lengths of the sides. So that was 2x plus 2y. Then we take our other equation, solve for y, and then plug it into our function p. And we have a pure function of x. And now we apply the second derivative test, which basically says take the derivative, set it equal to 0, do some algebra, and we ended up with x equals 10. We took the 10, plugged it into the formula for y, and we found y equals 10. But we never actually verified that 10 gave a minimum, so that's where the second derivative test comes in. So basically, you take the second derivative of p prime, you get p double prime, then plug in your answer, plug in your 10, and then in this case, it's positive, so we do indeed have a minimum. Kind of a long problem, but once you know how to do it, it's not too bad. I hope this video has been helpful, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.